two-horse race over in Italy as AC Milan and Atalanta lead the charge. But what about Inter Milan and Napoli? Can they get back into the race this weekend? We'll get into it next. Just 1 second. If you're new to the channel, smash your subscribe button. I keep you bang up to date with all things Serie A related, Blackburn Rovers related, World Football related. We're going to know here. And Roski, that's right. Of course, my boys, my tip for the top. Not my boys, but my tip for the top. AC Milan, so far so good. Atalanta also doing very well and scoring a buttload of goals. What's going to happen with those guys this coming match day? We'll get into it in just a second. A big shout out to the Patreon gang, that's right. Supporting the channel behind the piston scenes. I do appreciate those guys. There's 20 of them. And of course, their names scroll at the end of the screen. But if anyone wants to join that illustrious VIP gang, get stuck in the old description down there, patreon.com/roversees, and join the beloved brother from another gang. That's right. I do appreciate the support from the patrons. It does wonders for the older mentality, as I know this, guys. I appreciate the content. Anyway, let's jump in the deep end, of course, and have a look at how we all got on last time around in match day number trio. That's right. Here we go. 1-3. This is the criteria, folks. This might be a little bit off because it was a bit of a multi-match day last week, but anyway, not 1-3, 4, 7+. You're in the top banana. So kicking all off, Benny took Calcio there. They actually got humped in a 7-goal Bobby Dazzler against Inter Milan. Romelu Lukaku with a couple of goals. Roberto Gagliardini, Achille Carrifki and Lautaro Martinez on the score sheet for Inter Milan as they came out on top of the 5-2 win of Benevitaro. Gianluca Caparini getting the goals for Benny took Calcio. Actually, on the 3-0 win for Inter Milan, so not too shabby. Udinese against Spezia. Spezia surprised the odds there with a 2-0 win away from home of Udinese. The goal scorers on that day were Anthony Gabardino, and I've got a couple of goals for Spezia with Claudio Terzi getting himself sent off in the 65th minute, but still they held on for the big fat W. And Atalanta 4-1 winners over Lazio. Ruben Gusens, Hans Hutterbo and Alejandro Gomez with a couple of goals for Atalanta. Felipe Cesaro on the score sheet for Lazio in a 4-1 loss to Atalanta. I actually favoured Atalanta with a 3-2 win, so not too shabby from my point of view. Meanwhile, my boys, Sampdoria, 2-1 winners over Fiorentina on the Friday. Actually went against them. Actually went with Fiorentina for the victory, but Sampdoria came out on top. Goals from Fabio Quagliarella, still scoring, still at his old age. And Vavio Verdi on score sheet as well for Sampdoria. Dusan Vilinovic on score sheet for Fiorentina in a 2-1 loss. Meanwhile, Sassuolo Calcio took on FC Catone, and they won 4-1 in the end. Sassuolo's goals coming from Domenico Berardi, Francesco Puto with a couple of goals, and Manuel Caletti, as they came out 4-1 winners. Slimy or Simi on the score sheet for Crotone on this one. Genoa against Torino, that was postponed. We'll have to look at that game another time. Udinese against Roma was a 1-0 win for Roma on the day on that one. Where's the goal scorers on that one? Do we have it? Yes, we do. The 1-0 goal scorer was Pedro for Roma, of course, ex-Chelsea man on score sheet there. Actually, I remember the 2-1 win myself. Atalanta took on Cagliari, and they also won another 5-2. Bobby Dazzler scoring goals. 9 goals in the past 2 games for Atalanta as they came out on top. Goal scorers on this day, Loris Muriel, Andriando Gomez as well, Mario Palasilic, Duven Zapateta and Simon Lamias on the score sheet for Atalanta. Diego Godin and Joao Pedrillo on the score sheet for Cagliari in a 5-2 loss, going in favour of Atalanta on that one. Benevito took care of Bologna, wasn't it? 1-0 win in the end for Benevito. Get themselves up and running. Gianluca Lapadula on the score sheet for Benevento with a big fat W for them. Lazio and Inter Milan 1-1 in the end. I think Inter Milan would be happy with that. Lautaro Martinez on the score sheet once again. Sergej Milinkovic-Savic on score sheet for Lazio. Sirio Immobile and Stefano Sensi get themselves both sent off in a very, very hotly contested match. Meanwhile, Parma against Hellas Verona end up 1-0 win for Parma. Again, a big result that for Parma. Josimin Kurtic with one-only goal in the first minute. Actually, went with the 2-0 win for Hellas Verona. Shame on me. AC Milan against Spezia Calcio was a 3-0 win. I got this one bang on the nose, lads. Bang on the pissing nose with goals coming from Rafael Leao, Theo Hernandez. Leao got himself a couple of goals on this one in a 3-0 win to go top of the table. And Juventus against Napoli, that was a game that was postponed. And again, I actually would have went with a 3-2 win for Juventus, but we'll have to wait and see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 for me, which I think puts me in the top face gang. I don't know, but it's not about me, folks. It's not about me. This is the situation as it stands at the moment. Atalanta and AC Milan top of the pops as it stands. 3 wins out of 3. Sassuolo second, a third. Inter Milan are fourth, down the foot of the table. Crotone, Udinese and Torino going down as it stands. Torino do have a game in hand on the chasing pack, so maybe not maybe, they'll be down there. That's my picks, of course. What about you guys? Let's have a little look then, shall we, at what you guys did last time around. We're going to start with NJ. He did okay. Ultra Omen Murat, you did all right as well. Sander 99, not too shabby. Gaming Charlie did bits, hitting out of the park. Dave, what did you do? So you did all right. Depak the Great, not too bad. Hans Wurst, killing it as well. Hi, what did you do? You did okay. Bianca Moller did all right as well. Moving forward, Football Mapper did bits. Neil Gallagher, or Galilei, did all right. Yeah, she Top Banana, it smashed it out of the park. Samuel Collins did all right as well, hitting it out of the park. Bossio Mata, Top Banana, not Top Banana, did okay. Victor Cavallio, Top Banana for you, sir. Natasha A did okay. Very, very good, in fact. Matt Gunner, also killing it. Also killing it. Liam 2000, you did all right. Omaji Monday, also killing it as well. Shane O'Donnell, not too bad. LG Cow, you did okay, sir. Mike Gallagher did bits. Ishan Ishan, not too shabby. Yannick Buster, Top Banana as well. Over Escaville, the Mexican Sniper, not too bad. Ash Shepard also did very, very well. Smashing it, actually. Well done to you, sir. Alex Weller did bits. Dennis Kamali, both of you guys, round of applause as well. Vincent Hong, you did all right. Vic Costas K did okay. Nathan Heber did all right as well. And we are QPR, not too bad indeed. Into the back end. And in fact, that is it. This is the current situation for this week and this week alone in the All Prediction League. Your current leaders for this week was Omaji Monday with an impressive 9. David Charlie, Neil Galilei, Shepard, and Victor Carvalho. Look at that. Shepard doing bits. Yes. Get in there, my son. Moving on. Of course, this is your overall leaderboard. What have we got going on here? Ignore my scores. Your leader is Hans Wurst at the moment. He is your prediction king. So respect your prediction king. That is Hans Wurst as it stands. Omaji Monday, Gaming Charlie, and Shepard. Bloody well, Ultra Omen Murat up there as well with a 70% success rate. Victor Cavallo and Yannick Buster so far. That's not bad. 70% success rate. That's pretty killing it. It's still early days. There's only 3 games in, but still exciting. Still exciting. That, of course, was the predictions league as it stands. But let's get into it. See what happens in the next round of matches. Of course, match number 4 right here, right now. Napoli taking on Atalanta. Goals galore. I expect in this one. These two sides played each other 108 times in the past. 47 wins for Napoli, just 29 wins for Atalanta, and 32 draws. The last 6, though, sees 2 wins apiece. In fact, 2 wins for Napoli, 3 wins for Atalanta, and 1 draw. Last night, Pedro was in Atalanta. It was a 2-0 win for Atalanta. Mario Palasilic on the score sheet. Robin Gosens as well. However, last time played each other in Naples was a 2-2 draw back in October, right about this time last year, actually. Nikola Masakovic with Andrius Milic on the score sheet for Napoli, with Romeo Fula and Josip Ilinic on the score sheet for Atalanta. Heading into this, Atalanta have actually scored at least 4 goals in the last 3 matches, whereas Napoli have actually scored at least 2 goals in the last 10 home matches. They've also won 7 of the last 8 home matches as well. Two sides in ridiculous form, and they're just continuously winning games on this one. The bookies odds will find it difficult. 28-20 for Napoli, 6-4 for Atalanta, 30-5 is your draw. Napoli coming to this without a defeat so far, 2 wins out of 2, and a win for them could actually go joint top alongside Atalanta and AC Milan. This one's difficult to call, really is. But I'm going to give it to Atalanta. There's just something about them at the moment. I think they're just going to keep on winning. Keep on winning on. And I love it. I love it to see them really compete for the title this season. So I'm surprised that in most people's eyes. But I do believe they're onto something special this time. Of course, it is the Milan derby. Inter Milan taking on AC Milan. Of course, these two sides played each other 191 times in the past. 72 wins for Inter. 60 wins for AC. And 59 draws between these two sides. The last time I played each other was in Inter Milan. It was around February 2020. It was a 4-2 win. 6-goal Bobby Dazza. Ante Rebic and Zlatan on the score sheet for AC Milan in a 2-goal lead before Brozovic, Vecino, De Vrij and Lukaku turned the game on its head in a 4-2 win for Inter Milan. Last time, these two sides have actually the last 6 sees 4 wins for Inter Milan, 1 win for AC Milan and 1 draw. Milan have actually won their 8 of the last 9 matches in the division, and they've also kept a clean sheet in the last 4. So two sides in ridiculous form, and in fact Inter Milan are actually in worse form heading into this. So we'll have to see what happens there. The bookies odds will probably tight to call this one as well. So tight. I don't even have any odds. I don't even have odds on this one. They're not calling it. They're not calling it. But let's get into it then and have a little closer look. Of course, AC Milan coming to this in second. Inter Milan coming to this in third. 2 points separate the two sides. But it could be a situation where the two swap it over. Of course, I do like AC Milan. But I do think Inter Milan will have something to say about this one. So I'm going to give it a 2-2 draw. I can't separate two sides. Can you? What do you think about this one and the rest? Be sure to get your predictions in nice and early. Of course. Meanwhile, my boys Sampdoria taking on Lazio. These two sides played each other 111 times in the past. 26 wins for Sampdoria, 52 wins for Roma. Lazio, and 33 draws. The last 6, though, sees nothing for Sampdoria. 5 wins for Lazio and 1 draw. The last time played each other was in Rome as a 5-1 win back in January for Lazio, with Casasedo, Immobile, a hat-trick, and Bastos on the score sheet for Lazio. Cariolinetti on the score sheet for Sampdoria as they were smashed 5-1. Last time played each other in Sampdoria was a 3-0 win for Lazio as well. That was around about August 2019. Immobile with a couple of goals and Joaquim Carriera as well. Heading into this, Sampdoria have actually lost the last 3 home matches and conceding at least 2 goals in the last 3 as well. Not the greatest start for them, but of course they come into this on the back of a win. 1 win in the past 3 games. Meanwhile, Lazio just also 1 win in the past 3 games, but they also drew against Inter Milan not too long ago. The bookies will probably favour Lazio on this one. 14-5 for Sampdoria, 5-2 draws, 20-17 on Lazio, our red hot favourites for this one. Of course, Sampdoria are my boys and they do have a little bit of a soft spot for them, but I do expect Lazio to show their quality in the end. With a 2-0 win away from home, big for them to get themselves back into the discussion as well. Juventus, of course, slipping up a little bit, of course, not too long ago. 1 win, 1 draw so far. Of course, last time around, it was a draw. Taking on Crotone, of course, who've yet to really get going. In fact, 3 defeats on the spin for them. These two side pitchers, 6 times in the past. 5 wins for Juventus and 1 draw. The last time the pitcher, there was a draw, and it was in Crotone, in Serie A. 1-1 draw back in April 2018. Simi on the score sheet for Crotone, Alexandra on the score sheet for Juventus. Heading into this, Juventus actually conceded at least 2 goals in the last 5 away matches, whereas Crotone have actually lost the last 3 matches, both home and away. Bookies odds will probably give it to Juventus, nailed on, I'm pretty sure. 9-1 for Crotone, long shots. 92 is your draw. 92 on for Juventus. Don't call favourites, of course. And I'm going to give them a big victory with a 3-0 and no goals for Crotone as well. Moving into Sunday's games, Bologna taking on Sassuolo. These two sides have played each other 12 times in the past. 5 wins for Bologna, 4 wins for Sassuolo, and 3 draws. The last 6, though, sees 3 wins for Bologna, 2 wins for Sassuolo, and 1 draw. Last time played each other was in Bologna. It was back in lockdown as well. 8th of July, 2-1 win for Sassuolo. Dominic Berardi, Lucas Halsan on the score sheet for Sassuolo. Moussa Barra on the score sheet for Bologna heading into this, of course. So far, so good for Sassuolo. They're up there in the discussion as well. 7 points in the possible 9. Meanwhile, Bologna just 1 win in the past 3 games. That was against Parma, 4-1 winners as well. Bookies odds, 50-8 for Bologna, 5-2 is your draw, 6-5 is your away win. That is 6 Sassuolo, and they are the favourites, of course, looking good at the top of the table, just 2 points adrift of the leaders. I do expect another win for Sassuolo here with a 2-1 win away from home to take it to the house. Maybe an upset. Bologna are a sort of mid-table crunch clash, but they've so far not really got going. It's too many defeats for them out of 3. Moving forward, Spezia taking on Fiorentina. Fiorentina sitting in mid-table. Meanwhile, their opposition, Spezia, doing okay as well. Picking up 3 points out of a possible 9 in the return to the top 5. Anyway, these two sides, I don't think they've ever played each other, so this will be the first encounter. But coming into this, back-to-back defeats for Fiorentina, losing to Sampdoria and Inter Milan. Conceding 6 goals in the process. Meanwhile, Spezia come into this, of course, with the victory over Udinese not too long ago, but of course, most recently, a defeat against AC Milan. The bookmakers' odds on this one. 80-5 for Spezia, 6-4 on for Fiorentina. They are the favourites. 11-4 is your long shot, and a win for Fiorentina in 12th could actually see them leapfrog all the way up to 5th in the table, but a win for Spezia in 15th could be the same deal all the way up to 5th if they're victorious. I do expect a tight one. I'm going against the grain here. I'm going against the bookies, probably against the form book, and probably against all the other pundits, but I'm going to go with a 1-0 win for Spezia to take it over Fiorentina with a 1 cheeky nil win. Meanwhile, Torino taking on Cagliari. Torino yet to get going as well. 2 defeats of the past 2 games. Yet to really get going. Of course, last game was postponed. They're taking on Cagliari for the 73rd time. The previous 78, 28 wins for Torino, 20 wins for Cagliari, and 24 draws. The last 6 goes 2 wins for Torino, 1 for Cagliari, and 3 draws. Last time pitcher was in Cagliari. That was a 4-2 win for Cagliari as well. Nathan Nandandez, Joao Pedro, Giovanni Simeone with Radia Ngungalan as well on score sheet for Cagliari. Bremner and Andrea Bellotti on the score sheet for Torino. Last time that these two sides locked horns. Meanwhile, last time pitch of the in Torino was a 1-1 draw back in around about this time last year, actually. 1-1 draw. Simon Zaza, Nathan Nunez on the score sheet back in 27th of October 2019. Cagliari have actually failed to win 12 of the last 30 matches in Serie A. Torino have also failed to win their last 7 as well. So two teams looking for a win, looking for some points. They're even looking on eBay to try and get themselves moving. Torino, I guess Cagliari 6-5 for the hosts on this one. 2-1 for Cagliari. 23-10 is your very, very fine margin between these two sides, I think. For me, though, I'm going to go with a 0-0 draw. I can't separate two sides, especially I think if the game was in Cagliari, I think I would go with the visitors. But I think they'll be content with the new neutral away from home. Udinese taking on Parma, of course. These two sides locking horns for the 53rd time. The previous 52 times. 17 wins for Udinese, 23 wins for Parma, and 12 draws. The last six, though, sees nothing. Oh, sorry, the last four, nothing for Udinese. Three wins to Parma and one draw. The last time pitcher that was in Parma back in January 2020 was a 2-0 win for Parma. The goal scorers was Ricardo Galliguero and Dijan Kalinowski. However, the last time pitcher that in Udinese was also a win for Parma. It's actually been three wins in the spin for them. There's a 3-1 win last round, back around about September last year. Kevin Lasagna on the score sheet for Udinese. Jovino, Ricardo Castiglioglu, Roberto Inseglesi on the score sheet for Parma. Heading into this, Udinese actually had to score the last three matches, and they've also lost the last three home matches as well. Terrible start for the season for Udinese. Meanwhile, not the fantastic start either for Parma. One win in the past three games for them. Bookmakers odds, what do we have on this one then, shall we? We have 11-10 for Udinese. The other favourites, 23-10 for Parma. 9-4 is the draw. But so far, Udinese looking rotten. Johnny rotten at the moment. Parma not doing too much better. But of course, they come into this on the back of a win. Going with another win for myself, though. I'm going with Parma. Back-to-back wins and another defeat on the cards for Udinese as they continue to struggle this season. Moving on, Roma taking on Benevento. These two sides playing each other just for the fourth time. The previous two wins for Roma, one win for Benevento. And that last win was a friendly, doesn't really count. However, the last time played against Roma, in Roma, was back in 2018. It was a 5-2 win, 7-goal thriller in favour of Roma. Kuzengi under with a couple of goals. Gregor De Ferrier with a penalty. Edin Dzeko and Federico Fazio on the score sheet for Roma. Guglielmi and Enrico Brignola on the score sheet for Benevento. Heading into this, Roma are actually undefeated in the last 11 matches in Serie A, and they've also scored at least two goals in eight of the nine last matches for them. Benevento started off pretty good for them, picking up two wins at the past three games, looking with 6 points out of possible nine. Meanwhile, Roma not too great for them, just one win in the past three games as well. Bookies odds, we'll still give it to Roma, I'm pretty sure of it. We have 4-1 on for Roma. 4-1 is your draw. 8-1 is your long shots. With Benevento who come into this in 7th and win for them. Could go top of the table, books. Could go top of the table. Meanwhile, Roma in a 10th spot. Could go as high as 3rd with a big fat W as well. Despite Benevento's fantastic start, I do expect them to lose this one. 3-1 in the end, especially with Roma at home. And wrapping it up would be Hellas Verona. I'll take it on Genoa on the Monday Night Football on this bad boy. These two sides locking horns for the 42nd time. The previous 41, 12 wins for Verona, 14 wins for Genoa, and 15 draws. The last six, though, sees one win for Verona, four wins for Genoa, and one draw. The last time they played each other was in Genoa. It was a 3-0 win back in August 2020, and that was in lockdown as well. Antonio Zanibera with a couple of goals. Christian Romero as well. A couple of red cards there for Genoa. Romero and Castagna with Sonny and Adabat to get himself sent off as well. Last time they played each other in Verona was a 2-1 win for Verona. That was back in January 2020 with Valerio Verrieri and Mattia Sankangi on the score sheet for Verona, with Antonio Sanibeba get himself a goal as well. Heading into this, one win, one defeat so far for Genoa. Verona, two wins out of three games for them. Not too bad start for them. Verona have actually kept a clean sheet in the last three matches. Genoa have actually conceded at least two goals in five of the last six matches as well. The bookies odds on this one. What do we have on this? I'll tell you what we have. We have nothing. We don't have the odds. It's a mystery. It's a mystery between these two, so we don't know. But of course, Verona looking good at the moment, sitting sixth at the table. Genoa, of course, relegation favourites last time around. So far, just the 3 points for them to boot. I'm going to go with Verona on this one, away at home, to take it to the house. 2-1 win to put them on 9 points, and potentially that could go top of the pops, depending on what goes on elsewhere, my friends. That's it. That's what I think will happen in match day number four. And if I'm right, this is what the table would look like. It'll be a 100% start for Atalanta. 4 wins out of 4. With Sassuolo, AC Milan hot on the heels. Hellas Verona up to fourth as well. So that's the foot of the table. Crotone, Udinese and Torino going down as it stands. But of course, it is very, very early. Very, very early. Be sure to get your predictions in. Of course, we have got a live action prediction league with your predictions counting each and every week to see, of course, getting your own prediction ratio. And of course, see if you can come out on top against the chasing pack. That's it, my friends. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you did, smash that thumbs up. But if you are new, bang the subscribe. Of course, if you are to give yourself a bang up to with all things Serie A related, blab and roll related. More football. But today we got all here under one rooster. If you want to support the channel in another way, please check out the old description down below. Of course, links to my other social media platforms and, of course, Patreon. If you want to support the channel, that's the place to do it. That's the place to do it, folks. That's it. Atalanta looking good. So are AC Milan. But who's going to be out on top next week? We'll have a look at it next week, of course, because that's how it works. I'm out.